Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you some handy camera settings to make your composing easier inside a Blender. Also, if you're wondering what this table is, we actually made it in a previous tutorial, so feel free to check that out if you're interested in learning some Blender modeling. First of all, before we talk about any camera settings, I'm going to need to have a camera in my scene. So I'm going to press Shift and then A to open the add menu, and then I'm going to choose camera. Keep in mind, if you already have a camera in your scene, your active camera, if you don't know what an active camera is, I do have a video on it here, but it's pretty much, if I press Shift A and then add another camera, and press G and X, you can see my new camera doesn't have a black triangle, and that's because it isn't the active camera. The active camera is the one with the full or black triangle. And all that means is when I press this camera button, it's going to go into the active camera and leave this other camera alone. I'll left click my other camera and press X to delete it. Now I'm going to move my camera to a nice position, so I'm just going to line up my view roughly where I'd like my camera to be. Then I'm going to left click this view option, and then under align view, I'm going to choose align camera to view. And now you can see we've got our camera looking at our table here. I can also press G with my camera selected to kind of move it into position. Then I'm going to come down to this green camera option here in this properties menu, and I'm just going to scroll down to viewport display. If it's closed, you can just left click this arrow to open it. First of all, if I left click and hold this size parameter to increase the size, you'll notice no immediate change. This isn't really a super important option, but it can be handy sometimes. So I'm going to left click my camera button here to come out of camera view, and you'll notice that my camera looks a little bit bigger, and that's because we changed the size here. So you can see this just makes the camera maybe easier to click if it's using in a bigger scene, or vice versa. So I'm just going to keep it the default, which is 1, and I'm going to press this camera button to go back into the camera view. These options here, such as the limits for example, are more relevant to other settings. The limits one is more relevant to the depth of field options inside of Blender, so I'll be covering that in a separate tutorial where we go more in depth into that. We also have this option called name here, and when I turn this on, you can see the name of our camera will appear on the bottom left hand corner of our camera. Next up we have pass part out. This is quite handy to make what's in the camera view a little bit more clear for our eyes. So I'm just going to change this value all the way up to 1, and you can see we can now only see exactly what's inside of the camera. I like to use this option quite a lot, and you can notice if I turn it off, it makes it a little bit harder to see what's in the camera, especially when we're trying to compose a nice image. I'm going to turn it back on, and next up we have this option here called composition guides, which I can just left click to open. If you're familiar with the rule of thirds, which is essentially the idea in composition that our eyes like it when we have a significant focal point in one third and maybe an important but not as important object in another third, this guide can be really handy for you to make sure you position your object in one of these thirds. I'll turn that off, and you'll see we also have a center option as well. This is just going to show us where the middle of the camera is, which is good if you want to make a nice symmetrical image. You can of course turn both of these on at the same time. We also have diagonal, which will also show the center point, but it's going to be drawing lines from the corners instead. Also, if you like to use the golden ratio for your composition, we do have some golden ratio options here. I don't really tend to use this because I'm not really a massive fan of the golden ratio. I prefer to use the rule of thirds or the center options. We also have an option called Harmony, which I believe is another composition technique, but I'm actually not too familiar with this one. But if you happen to be familiar with it, then you've got some options and guides for it here too, which is really handy. And yeah, that's just about it. Just a few options to help you compose your images in Blender with the camera. If you want to learn a little bit more about the camera, I do have a few videos on it, which you can check out in this playlist here. But apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.